Hello everyone, in this tutorial we will learn how to use MATLAB toolbox for fitting data. So let's start. So my first question is, we need to fit this data which is given in the table with the appropriate polynomial. So just see this data. I will use the toolbox to fit this data. Since we will not use the code, I will directly go to the MATLAB for fitting this data. Now you can see that I have written the same data over here in my editor in MATLAB, and then simply what I have to do, I have to run this so that x and y get the values. So my x is now given as this, which I have shown you in my presentation, and my y is this. Now what we have to do, we have to open the curve fitting toolbox. So the curve fitting toolbox can be easily done by just writing this code, that is CF tool. You can simply write this in the command window, or the another way is that you have to go to this app and then you can press this curve fitting. And obviously this toolbox should be installed in the MATLAB, then only you can open it. You can also install if it is not from this, right, from this icon. If you will press and you will write the package that you want to install curve fitting toolbox, if it is not installed in your system, it will get installed. Now I will open with writing this code CF tool, and then I will press enter. So after pressing enter, you will see that you will get this type of window that is getting opened. Now you can rename your file over here, that data example 1. And now if you press on this x data, you can see that already the x variable is given over here. This is the same which you have given in your editor, which you have written in your editor, and then you have press run button and it is automatically importing the data from there. So you will put in the x data x, and you can see that it has plotted it over here, and y data as y. Now you can see that these are the points, these are the data, the black dots are the data. Now you can see that this is fitted by a line which is not a good fit. So why this is happening? This you can select, that you want to select polynomial for fitting, right? And you can increase the degree. For example, this is the first degree fitting. And you can see that here my sum of square error is very large, right? And r square error is also large, and root mean square error is also very large. So what we have to do, we have to increase the degree. For suppose if I make it as 2 degree, again it is not a good fit. Then 3 degree, it is okay but very not very good. Then 4 degree, it is like better. Then we can see that this 5 degree is giving us a very good fit. And if you see in your left hand side, this is the polynomial that is getting fitted for the data, and values of p1, p2, p3, p4, p5 and p6 is given over here, and this will show you how good your data is fitted. And you can see that sum of square error is less in this case. Obviously you can increase depending upon the number of data you have. So this is again a very good fit. So you know how you can get a approximate function for the given data. So this is the polynomial. It is a 6 degree polynomial. You can write all the coefficients from here, and this will give you a very good fit for the given data. And obviously if somebody asks you for what is the value at x is equal to say 2, then simply you can put 2 in x and you can give your answer. So now let us do the second experiment. This was very simple experiment. So in the second experiment, you have to import the data of infected cases from this website, right? You have to import from the website given over here, and then you need to fit the data with the MATLAB toolbox. So let's take some data from this website and have a good fit in the MATLAB toolbox. So as you can see, this is my website, and then scroll a bit down so that we can get the data. So you need to press now this icon for getting the data. When you will press this, you will see that another tab will get open, and then you have to download the data. So I will download the case time series from this by pressing this button, right? If you press this button, you will see that your data will be downloaded. Now I am opening the Excel file so that you can see the data. So this is the Excel file which is containing all the data. This contains daily confirmed, right, total confirmed, daily recovered, total recovered, daily deaths and total deaths, right? So what we have to do now, we have to add one more column in I, say for days, because MATLAB do not take the values as this because it is given in date. So we have to increase one more column, and we have to give like this one is our first day, like when the case was found, this was the first day. Then for making it till continuous, what you have to do, just type 1, then you need to increase it. So how you can do it in Excel, just if you go to this and you write the code over here in the formula bar, and again what you need to do is that you need to now see that this symbol comes, and then you need to drag it down till you find the data. Now you can see that it will get automatically filled, and here are the number of days. Now what you need to do is that save this Excel file. Now the work of the Excel file is done. Now we will go to the, so now we have saved our file. So now what we have to do, we have to import our data. So I will tell you a very simple way of importing the data. You need to go to this home tab, and then you have to select this import data. Then you have to go to the place where you have stored your data. For example, I have stored in downloads. So I will just open the file, and you can see that you can see every column over here. Now you have to make sure that the output type is column vector, not the table. By default it may be table, but you have to select the output type as column. Now I am importing all the data. So you have to just select this import selection. Now when this is done, you can close this, and you can see that all the data are now imported in a different column. You can see over here. Now what you have to do, you have to go to your toolbox, and you can name, rename it as COVID data, because this is you are working on COVID data. And for the X data, you can select the column days which you have created. Like earlier there was no column for days, and you have created it from 1 to 600 something. So you have to select that in X data. And now Y data, whatever you want to fit, like if you want to fit daily confirmed, just select this, and you will see that this is the black one. I am just increasing the size of the screen. This is the black one, is the data which it has imported from your Excel file, and this is the line that is giving you the fit. But you can see that this is not a good fit, and if you use the polynomial and even of the higher degree, you will not see a very good fit. So let us change this fitting. Like rather than using this polynomial, we can use Gaussian. And if you use the Gaussian to fit this data, you will see that now the data is this black one and the fitted curve is this blue one. This is not a good fit, so we can increase the number of terms. So if we increase the number of terms, now you can see that when I increase the number of term to 3, you can easily check out over here that now my blue one is getting over the black dots. If I increase it with 4, you can now see that it is improving, the fit is improving. And here you can see the goodness of fit parameters are given over here. This is sum of the square error, and this is R square, adjusted R square, and root mean square error. So this is the Gaussian function which is fitting the data. So you can see that all the parameters are given over here, and This is the function which we are getting for fitting the COVID situation data. Like these are the daily confirmed cases. Now if you want to fit like take another data like daily deaths data, then you can also import the data and you can see that this one is also giving a good fit, right? For daily deaths also this Gaussian, and if I use number of terms as 4, this is also giving a good fit. So by this you can import any type of data, and MATLAB has given many inbuilt functions that you can use for fitting the data, and you can get your functions over here with all the parameter values given over here, with also with all the error parameter also illustrated over here. It was very simple to import the data and to fit the data with the help of this toolbox. We can also use the MATLAB code, like we can write the codes in MATLAB in the editor and then we can also fit the data. But this is a simple toolbox which is already provided by MATLAB, which can be used for fitting up the given data. So now I will end this tutorial over here. Thank you.